In this tutorial, I'm going to show how to use iMovie for iOS version 2.1.1 to edit a video on an iPhone. You'll first have to download iMovie from the App Store and tap it to open. You'll be presented with a marquee screen showing the video files on your phone. Tap Projects and you will see any video projects you've created. It's easiest to work in landscape view, so let's switch to that view. To create a new project, tap the plus sign in the upper right corner. You'll then have two options, make a movie or a movie trailer based on a template. We're going to select movie. You will now see a project window with two main panels. The upper panel is the browser and viewer window, and the lower panel is the timeline where your media will be added to build the video. The various tools are indicated by buttons alongside the main panel. We'll work through these as we build a video. Let's start by adding some video clips. To access your media files, tap the Media button, then select Video at the bottom. Tap the top line to see all video files, which you can scroll through. To select a clip, tap on it and it will be outlined in yellow. Tap the Play button and you can review the clip. You can select the exact portion of the clip you wish to use by dragging the yellow bars inward, clipping off, trimming off the parts that you do not wish to add to your timeline. Once you are ready, tap the Insert button and the trim clip drops into the timeline. And you can review by tapping the Play button in the toolbar. Let's add some more clips to work with. Note that wherever the playhead is located, this is the vertical white line. This is where your media will always be added. Also notice the orange lines that appear on clips in the browser window show which footage has been used. And let's add another one. And maybe one more. Maybe this one. Okay. To move a clip, all you have to do is just press on it with your finger, and then you can drag it to wherever you want it in the timeline. Then just release it. You can expand the view of your clips using the pinch zoom gesture on your phone screen, like this. This doesn't change the clip duration, just the number of frames visible to you in the timeline window. Pinching them closed lets you see and manipulate all of your clips more easily. Tap on a clip in the timeline and various options appear. The scissors lets you trim or split a clip, detach the audio track, duplicate or delete a clip. Let's split this clip by placing the playhead and tapping Split. Now that clip is split into two parts. We can also detach the audio. And once detached, we can move it somewhere else in the timeline. Just grab it and drag it to another position. If you make a mistake, tap the Undo button. Let's look at some other options. And I think let's go to another clip, this one. So tap the clip and the options appear again. And this time we're going to tap the clock. That allows us to change the speed or add a freeze frame. And here I've slowed the speed of the clip down somewhat. We can also change the volume of the clip by tapping the audio button. Tapping the text icon will let you add text titles to any clip. You can select among several options as well as the position in the center of the frame or lower. Tap the text box and the keyboard appears. And just type in whatever text you want. And I'll add Natural History Museum, since these clips were recorded in the Natural History Museum in London. Now we can review to see how the text will look when the video plays. Okay, so that looks pretty good. You can shoot footage while in iMovie. Just tap the camera icon, and this opens the camera application on your phone. Then tap the record button to start and stop the recording. I'm just shooting my bookshelves, but you get the idea. When you accept the recording, it drops right into your timeline, wherever your playhead was sitting. So this gives you another option for adding footage to your timeline. To add still images to your video, these are stored in your photo library. Just select Media and then Photos at the bottom of the screen. And this opens your library. And just tap the image that you wish to add, and it automatically drops it into your timeline wherever your playhead was sitting. So there's one image, and let's pick one more, perhaps the image of the dodo. You can add motion to a photo by adding a Ken Burns effect. So select the clip, and then notice it says pinch to position the start and the end. And so we can reposition both the beginning and the end of that photo clip, and when we play it, you can see it scans across and focuses in on the head of the dodo. Tap the text icon to add a title to the photo, as we did for the video clip. We can also add a filter by tapping the icon with three spheres, and there are several options here. You can also change the duration that an image appears in the video by dragging one of the yellow bars and expanding the length of that photo clip. These little icons between the clips create transitions, and we can change the type of transition. There are several choices. A cut transition, a theme transition, a dissolve transition, a slide transition, and wipe and fade. And let's take a look at what the slide transition looks like. So one image just slides over to the next. But let's go back to the dissolve transition. So one image dissolves into the next image. You can also change the duration of the transition from 0.5 to 2 seconds. You may want to record a voiceover for your video. To do this, just tap on the microphone and then tap record. You get a 3-second countdown. Then the audio recording starts. When you're finished, tap stop, and you're given the option to cancel, retake, review, or accept. And we will accept. And this will put an audio track beneath the video clip. Note that you can move these audio tracks around, or you can delete it by dragging it out of the timeline. Next, you might want to add some music or sound effects to your video. Tap on the audio icon and then tap on Theme Music. You can preview each one by touching the play button. Then when you find one you like, tap it and it drops into your project timeline and appears as a green track below your main video track. Tapping the music track will select it, allowing you to trim it, change the speed, or the volume. You can add sound effects as well. Go back and select sound effects, and you're given a number of options of various types of sounds. And let's pick one to add, perhaps crickets. So tap the add button and it drops into the timeline. And we can move that track to another spot, perhaps adjacent to a photo. By tapping on the project settings button, we can change the entire theme of the video. And there are a number of options. Changing the theme will change the text, the transitions, and the music, assuming you've selected theme for those items. You can override the theme, for example, by selecting a non-theme text title format. Tapping the question mark in the upper right-hand corner identifies buttons and leads you to more instructions about iMovie. Once you've got everything the way you want it, you can preview the video by going back to the marquee screen. And here you can tap the play button to preview your movie full screen. Or you can tap the share button, which opens up a list of options. iMovie Theater will send it to iCloud, or you can upload directly to Facebook, YouTube, or to another video sharing site. And you can also save a rendered file to your camera roll on your phone by selecting Save Video. And you can go back and edit by tapping the thumbnail of your movie. That's a brief overview of iMovie for iOS to get you started editing videos. There are additional features that I've not covered, but that you can discover on your own. If you get stuck or have a question, just use the help option. For more tips and tutorials, please check out my ebook, The Scientist Videographer.